least for 18 months, I just have to do it. My name is Tim Bauer, and I'm a candidate for nothing, and I approve this message. 2 weeks ago, in Fear Factor's video, this was the yard that was filled with Halloween decorations. Boy, how quickly things change, and I can't expect everybody to decorate for every holiday, but it sure doesn't seem like Thanksgiving gets much attention at all. Even turkeys deserve more respect than this. And how do decorations for Halloween get so much attention, and yet this is the best we can do? Having been an empty nester for over a decade and moving closer to the 70-year milestone, holiday meals just aren't as big as they used to be. And sometimes my appetite isn't as big as it is or has been in the past. So a friend of mine sent me this idea for Thanksgiving. I think it has some validity. Anybody who knows me knows that this is not my kind of store. Sure, I can get basic supplies, but doing anything maintenance-wise or repair-wise is only frustrating for me. But every now and then, I gotta go pick up some light bulbs, cleaning supplies, and just see the sights. Before the journey into Menards happens, I want to tell you about a podcast I listen to, which is one of the most eclectic podcasts I've heard in a long time. The two main characters on the podcast are J.J. Gordon and Tucker Lucas. The podcast is entitled J.J. Meets World. They're real, they're earthy, and if you want to listen to them, you'll see the name up here on the video pretty soon. But one of the later ones that they've had, in all of their discussions, they got talking about popcorn. You know, popcorn. This kind of stuff. Most popcorn, it's oil, you put some salt on it, it's a savory snack. But then there's that stuff that's often done at fairs or other special events called kettle corn. Made in a kettle, but instead of it being savory with salt, it's sweet because they use sugar in the kettle and air pop it, and it gets a certain coating on it, and I'm sure many of you have had that. Well, anyway, they got into a discussion about kettle corn and flavored popcorn. So when I was in the store, a couple pictures for you that'll be coming up shortly, but I want you to think about, is it popcorn that's flavored, or is it kettle corn? Even though it says on the package it's kettle corn, isn't kettle corn its own flavor? Isn't it its own product? That kettle corn is a flavor. So then if all of a sudden you drizzle it with all of this other stuff, is it still kettle corn? Or is it coated corn? It's been sugar coated and then they drizzle on all sorts of other stuff. Anyway, just a question for you. Saw this on my way through the home improvement store. I know for a few of you that watch this, and probably a lot of other people you know, Christmas is the big season. You know, I don't know if there's Christmas music started already, if the, I don't know, Hallmark Channel has gone to all Christmas all the time. I don't know, but here again in the home improvement store, one of those things that I really don't quite understand, but I think it's kind of funny.
So what exactly makes this enchanted? I'm not quite certain. Is it a forest? It looks like a forest of artificial to me. We are a strange lot.
Speaking of eclectic, here I go. When I was a young child, one of the big things our family used to do is every Friday we would go in from the farm to a neighboring town and do our shopping. But one of the big treats we got to do was to eat at the local cafe. And I remember these small little green bottles, Mountain Dew. So my bizarre question for you. Is Mountain Dew a flavor or is it a brand name? Mountain Dew. No, you can't find the green little bottles anymore with the kind of the Appalachian person and a outhouse on it and all of that marketing they did then. But another picture for you. Is Mountain Dew a flavor? And a particular brand? Or is it simply a marketing ploy and then you put all kinds of other flavors in it? Just a thought. So you may be asking yourself, what is this video all about, because it's kind of strange and doesn't have necessarily a flow to it until this point. The title, Blues and Reds. The blues, pretty easy for me to get caught into that with less daylight as seasons change and as we went to standard time from daylight time and with the changing seasons. It's windier, it is damper, it just seems to be kind of depressing at times, and it seems like there's just way too much darkness. And then you throw on top of that all the hype that's done about the elections and what it may mean and the economy, and it is real easy to not only have the blues, but even go a little deeper into the blues. So it's not about colors of maps. It's not about, you know, which state is a blue state or a red state. I'm saying it's easy to get down in life. And you add to that the reality of humanness. Humans are not always consistent. Humans deal with a lot of hypocrisy. Humans make a lot of promises that they don't necessarily keep. It's just part of life, and the more I try to accept that, the better it becomes in my life, a more stable kind of life. And yet, at times, the blues sink in. So then you have the reds. Red, maybe in the season of Christmas, it brings a different feeling about life. Red at Valentine's Day, it's an idea of love. But overall, red is a color of passion, of courage, of activity. I think in the midst of the blues, it's good to have some reds to laugh, to think about what a wonderful world this is, even in the midst of all of those things we can't change. So the purpose of
this video is hopefully to make you smile, make you laugh, perk up your attitude, because it's easy to be blue, but it's a whole lot more enjoyable to celebrate the Reds. Once again, thank you for watching, and enjoy Louis Armstrong.